We are having a Roman breakfast here, and maybe Lia can tell us about what we see in front of us. It seems like a lot to me.
Well, there are quite a few Roman things or Italian things. The essential is espresso, caffè espresso. And then in Italy, we generally have a very quick breakfast. So people have an espresso or tea, like myself, and then there is a cornetto, which is brioche or croissant. And we have something very Italian, which is a pizza romana, which is a kind of a bread.
It looks like a focaccia a little bit.
Yes,
but it's not.
But it's called pizza romana.
Okay.
There are different kinds of focaccia in different cities in Italy, and in Rome there is this one.
Mm-hmm. I was just wondering, and what does do these things also have names? I mean, is this just normal cake, or do they have particular names?
This is torta della nonna. It's grandmother's cake.
Uh-huh.
This is what we call also in Italian Danish pastry.
Uh-huh.
And this is
just
cakes.
Cake.
This is a crostata.
Uh-huh.
With jam.
Okay, so I will try some of the grandma's cake, maybe. It looks very interesting.
It's nice. It's probably the most, alongside with the cornetto, is probably
the best,
the most Italian thing.
Ah, okay. I've never tried it. And maybe you can tell us a little bit about yourself.
I'm a member of parliament and member of the Foreign Affairs Committee. I belong to the Partito Democratico, which is the ruling party in Italy, mm-hmm. Renzi's party.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe people from abroad know it. This time we've deeply renovated parliament mm-hmm. in Italy. So we have the youngest parliament in history of the Republic of Italy.
Uh-huh.
And I belong to a new generation of members of parliament of different parties.
Are you above or below the average now? I mean, I'm sure you're still very much below the average.
I am below the average, but there are many colleagues that are younger than me. We elected
really?
People that are 25, 26 years old.
Oh, that's yes. very surprising.
Yes.
Renzi chose them?
We, as a party, we chose them through primary elections.
So I know that you were elected in Milan, so you divide up your life between Milano and Roma. How does that work on a daily basis?
It works more on a weekly basis.
Uh-huh.
I stay 3 or 4 days in Rome and the rest of the week in Milan.
Mm-hmm.
And I think this is a very good thing to do because Rome and Milan are two different cities.
Mm-hmm.
They are equally beautiful,
mm-hmm.
but they have goods and bads,
mm-hmm.
which I can see throughout the week.
Mm-hmm.
Milan is smaller, it's a lot more efficient,
mm-hmm.
but the weather is not as beautiful as in Rome,
yeah.
and the city is not as beautiful as Rome.
Mm-hmm.
And so it is very, very good to be able to work in
mm-hmm.
the two cities.
Thank you for being with us.
Thank you very much.